2009 GMC Yukon XL. I normally drive a 2003 PT Cruiser in red. I'm driving the Yukon because my PT Cruiser is broken and I can't drive it right now. So my dad lent me this Yukon. My dad's an electrician, so he has like three or four work trucks, and this is just one of his work trucks. I hate that it's really dirty on the inside and there's like a bunch of rust on it and it's not the prettiest vehicle. So, yeah. I think that the Yukon gets like 11 miles per gallon. It also costs $120 to fill it up, which is really hard because I'm a college student, so. I like that it sounds like a bus when I'm driving it because it goes. I don't ever use it for its intended purpose. The most people have had in this is like four, including me. So it's also not a family sedan. There's also three rows of seats. I don't know like who's having that many children. It's really concerning to me, but I don't plan on having like seven kids, so I think it's obnoxiously large in the back. Most of the people that I see driving this on the road are like my dad's age, and they're towing something with it, like a lawnmower, or I don't know, but there's never anybody my age that I know or see driving a Yukon XL in white. If I could get any car, it would probably be a 1977 Firebird in blue. I've had the Yukon for like 5 months now, and it's full of my dad's tools in the back. As you can see, like I don't even know half the stuff that's in there, but my dad makes me lock it every time I leave it because he says that people could steal them. So I lock it every time I leave. So yeah, I would own my own Yukon, but I get it in blue and I get like a bunch of modified things to it. I think that cars are to get from point A to point B, but I also think that they are a really great representation of your personality. Like, I think all people put a lot of thought into their cars. Like, they name them, and they work on them, stuff like that, so.